Now, yesterday we had seen that solids can be when we are talking about the conductivities, it can be divided into three categories, which are conductors, semiconductors, and insulators. And we had seen that the conductors had their valence band and the conduction band overlapping with each other, is it not? This we had seen yesterday. So they have their conduction and valence bands overlapping. This is my conduction band and this is my valence band. Sorry, I'm extremely sorry. This is my valence band and they overlap. So at any moment I have so many free electrons that can be pushed around if even the slightest of the fields is applied. And how do I apply the field? I apply the field through a cell or a battery or maybe whatever, but currently I'm talking about a DC field that you apply, fine. Now we come to the semiconductors. This is their valence band, and we know why there are bands, because it is a solid, and all those discrete lines, they actually diffuse, kind of, they are so many that they form a band. And I have my conduction band something like this. Now the gap between the valence band and the conduction band is termed as EG. Okay? It is EG is energy band gap. Energy band or I'll say band gap energy. Band gap energy. Okay? In semiconductors, this EG has to be less than 3 electron volts. Okay? It has to be less than 3 electron volts for it to be termed a semiconductor. And in silicon, in germanium, we have our EG less than 3 electron volts. Fine? Now, we come to an insulator. So, in an insulator, this energy, this band gap energy, this band gap energy has to be greater than 3 electron volts. So this is less than 3 electron volts. Here it is. Greater than 3 electron volts. Okay, here it is. Greater than 3 electron volts. Okay, now what does it imply? It implies that for an electron here, I'll have to impart, say if it is greater than 3 electron volt and it is equal to say 5 electron volt, then if this electron gets an energy of 5 electron volt, it will jump into the conduction band and will be free from its parent atom and hence in a position to move about when the field is applied. Okay. Now what happens is this. Yeah. If it gets say EG is 5 electron volts, then an electron getting an energy of 5 electron volts from maybe the thermal, normally they get it from ambient thermal energy. If it gets that much amount of energy, it will jump into the conduction band and will now be in a state where if you apply the field, it will conduct electricity. Okay. Now what happens? If this electron goes here, then it leaves a hole out here. Okay, it leaves a hole out here. Now what happens? It has been proved that the holes also help in conduction. Okay, the holes, they also help in conduction. I'll show you shortly how. Okay, so here suppose this jumps and it goes here, I have a hole left out here. Okay, at normal temperatures, the conductivity at normal temperatures and in a pure conductor, in a pure semiconductor, okay, in a pure semiconductor, what is a pure semiconductor called? It is called an intrinsic semiconductor. It is called an intrinsic semiconductor. In a pure semiconductor, which is called an intrinsic semiconductor, the conductivity is too low to be of any practical use, Okay, it has no use whatsoever. Still, it is being used everywhere in designing all the gadgets. We'll understand how. Okay, here what happens? Insulators require a huge amount of energy to transfer electrons from the valence to the conduction band. So what happens? In insulators, if you heat it up, the temperature goes up, and it can happen due to so many reasons. What could be the reason? Maybe the ambient temperature has gone up. Summer season. Okay? The ambient temperature goes up, you'll find so many cases of electrical fires. Why? Because the chances of shorting, that goes up. Okay? Or maybe there is a connection that you have done and it's a sparking connection, so it produces heat and gradually it will deteriorate the insulation around it and the insulation shorts. Okay, it is said that every 10 degree rise above the designed temperature for insulation, okay, insulation, the life of the insulation becomes half of what it was meant to be. You understand? So there are insulations which are designed to run at say 130 degree centigrade. So if you take it at 140, the life becomes half. And when I say the life becomes half, it is not the insulation's life which becomes half, it is your equipment's life which becomes half. Okay? Because many a times winding the equipment will entail a cost of about 40% of the whole equipment, or maybe even more. Okay? And it is a time consuming process, it is a very specialized process, and you might not find people who will be ready to do that. That is true for big motors. So big motors, the big generators, okay? And the downtime will affect you so harshly that it will cross even 100% of the cost of the equipment. Okay, so insulations play a major role in the electrical and electronics industries, and failure of insulation is maybe the failure of the industries altogether. Okay, so fine, that is when we are gunning for that. This is for conductors. Here we have the semiconductors. Now the property which is not so very attractive when they are in their pure state suddenly turns into something else the moment you make it impure by a process called doping. If you mix an impurity, then it is, the process is called doping. So doping is the process of mixing an impurity into an intrinsic semiconductor. And we somehow relate impurity with something evil, negative, right? But that is not the case in this semiconductor. Here, when you dope it, it actually becomes gold for you. Okay, that is where its use comes in. The doped semiconductor is called extrinsic semiconductor, is called extrinsic semiconductor. Fine? This is called an extrinsic semiconductor. Here it is called an intrinsic semiconductor. This process is called doping. Okay? This is doping. Fine? We understand? It's called an extrinsic semiconductor. Now we'll go into the discussion of how we dope it. Is it anything that we put into it? No. There is a specific impurity that transforms its character. Okay? And we'll be using that.